My name is Yaw Okraku-Yirenkyi. I was born here in Accra, spent maybe the first 12 years of my life here in Accra, and my parents shipped me off to the western part of the country where I had my secondary education, that is Takoradi. Then also spent some time in Kumasi for my first degree. My favorite subject in secondary school was mathematics. Actually, there were a few of them, mathematics and then metalwork and woodwork. In university, I did electrical electronic engineering for my first degree. For my master's and PhD, electrical electronic engineering for the master's and then systems engineering for the PhD. And this is what I have been using all along, even here at the Kofi Annan ICT Center for my work. And even in my own home, there are so many challenges that pop up all the time, and it saves me a lot of money, a lot. My job title here is Director of Studies, that is the Ghana India Kofi Annan Center of Excellence in ICT. I'm in charge of training here. The center was set up to build capacity in ICT for Ghana and the West African sub-region. But since it's set up, we have extended our training or our capacity building capabilities to include East Africa, South Africa, and also some partnerships with our European partners delivering training across the continent of Africa. What we seek to do with GRAF is to create problem solvers right from the primary level through junior high school to senior high school, all the way to university. And we are doing that through a program we call the Robotics Inspired Science Education, RISE. Since 2011, when we started this initiative, we now have close to 4,000 students all over the country participating in this initiative. We have been to a number of World Robot Olympiad starting 2012. Also earlier this year, sometime in May, a group of students from two senior high schools represented Ghana in the RoboFest Challenge, which is held every year in Southfield, Michigan. And I'm happy to let everybody know that one of the teams came up on top as far as innovation. They won the Toyota Innovation Award. So we can see that this problem-solving skills is playing such a massive role. It is actually leading to greater performances in your regular subjects, and it's also giving quite a number of them the opportunity to get scholarships to study in a few countries around the world. My advice to young people, right from primary through junior high school to senior high school, there are so many problems around us. And those who will be able to find solutions to the problems around them, in my view, are the ones who make the world tick. Science, technology, engineering, mathematics is what you need to solve the problem around you. You would need some discipline, maybe staying up a little bit late, keeping to a schedule, to do your experiments, to do all the brain cracking, the analysis, teamwork, all of those things will pull together. So STEM, again I say, is life. It is that which brings the solution that is needed for the many challenges around the world, especially our part of the world. We come from a place where there is so much of problems surrounding us, and we can find simple, inexpensive solutions to this problem, and you are the ones who will bring about the change. You live here, you know what it takes, and for those, let's say in the US, you know your environment too. So you will be the ones who apply all of these principles and bring about the solution that the world needs. We can make a world a better place.